Over the past many years, different networks were built and used for different hardware and software implementations. As a result, they were not suitable that time, and it became difficult for networks using different specifications to communicate with each other. To find out the problem of networks being incompatible and unable to communicate with each other, the International Organization for Standardization, that is ISO, investigated various network schemes. The ISO recognized there was a need to develop a network model that would support vendors to create ability to share data between different computer networks. The ISO is responsible for an extensive range of standards, including many that are appropriate to networking. In 1984, in order to support network interconnections without necessarily requiring complete redesign, the Open System Interconnections, called OSI Reference Model, was accepted as an international standard for communications design.
The Open System Interconnection, OSI model, is a reference tool for understanding data communication between any two networked systems. OSI divides the communications processes into seven layers. Each layer performs exact functions to support the layer above it and propose services to the layers below it. The three lowest layers concentrate on passing traffic through the network to the end system. The top four layers come into play in the end system to complete the process. A networking model offers a generic means to separate computer networking functions into multiple layers. Let's see the main benefits of the OSI model. It helps users to understand the big picture of networking. It helps users to understand how both hardware and software elements function together. It makes troubleshooting easier by separating networks into manageable pieces. It defines terms that networking professionals can compare basic functional relationships on different networks. It helps users to understand new technologies as they are developed. It helps in interpreting vendor explanations of product functionality. Now, the seven layers of the Open Systems Interconnection, OSI, reference model from top to bottom are: Layer 7, Application Layer; Layer 6, Presentation Layer; Layer 5, Session Layer; Layer 4, Transport Layer; Layer 3, Network Layer; Layer 2, Data Link Layer; Layer 1, Physical Layer. Next, we will discuss the characteristics of the OSI model layer. The seven layers of the OSI reference model can be divided into two parts: upper layers and lower layers. The upper layers of the OSI model deal with application issues and generally are implemented only in software. The highest layer, that is application, is closest to the end user. Users and application layer, both processes interact with software applications that contain a communication module. The term upper layer is sometimes used to refer to any layer above another layer in the OSI model. The upper layer includes application, presentation, and session layer. The lower layers of the OSI model handle data transport issues. The physical layer and the data link layer are implemented in hardware and software. The other lower layers are generally implemented only in software. The lowest layer, the physical layer, is closest to physical network medium. For example, the network cabling, which is responsible for placing information on the medium. The lower layer includes transport, network, data link, and physical layer.
The The OSI model provides a concept framework for communication between computers, but the model itself is not a method of communication. Actual communication is made possible by using communication protocols.
In data networking, a protocol is a formal set of rules and agreements that governs how computers exchange information over a network medium. Protocol implements the functions of one or more OSI layers. A wide diversity of communication protocols exists, but all tend to fall into one of the next groups, that is, LAN protocols, WAN protocols, routing protocols, and network protocols. LAN protocols operate at the physical and data link layers of the OSI model and define communication over the various LAN media. WAN protocols operate at the lowest three layers of the OSI model and define communication over the various wide area media. Routing protocols are network layer protocols that are responsible for route determination and traffic switching. Network protocols are the various upper layer protocols that exist in a given set of protocols. Now, it is important to know the role of seven layers in data transfer from one system to another. Data being transferred from a software application in one computer system to a software application in another computer system must pass through each of the seven layers of OSI model. This can be understood by an example. If a software application in system I has data to transmit to software application in system J, the application program in system I will pass its data to application layer, that is layer 7 of system I. The application layer then passes the data to the presentation layer, that is layer 6, which transmits the data to the session layer, that is layer 5, and so on down to the physical layer, that is layer 1. In the physical layer, the data is placed on the physical network medium and is sent across the medium to system J. The physical layer of system J removes the data from the physical medium, and then its physical layer passes the data up to the data link layer, that is layer 2, which passes it to the network layer, that is layer 3, and so on until it reaches the application layer, that is layer 7 of system J. Finally, the application layer of system J transmits the data to the recipient application program to complete the communication process. The layer in the OSI model generally interacts with three other OSI layers: the layer directly above it, the layer directly below it, and its peer layer in other network computer systems. For example, the data link layer in system I communicates with network layer of system I. The physical layer of system I and data link layer in system J.
One OSI layer communicates with another layer to make use of services provided by the second layer. The services provided by neighboring layers help a given OSI layer to communicate with its peer layer in other computer systems.
Three basic elements involved in layer services are the service user, the service provider, and the service access point, that is SAP. In this context, the service user is the OSI layer that requests services from an adjacent OSI layer. The service provider is the OSI layer that provides services to the service users. OSI layers can provide services to multiple service users. The service access point, that is SAP, is a conceptual location on which one OSI layer can request the services of another OSI layer.
We have discussed the role of layers in data transfer. Now, it is essential to understand the process of information exchange between two systems. The seven OSI layers use various types of control information to communicate with their peer layers in other computer systems. This control information includes specific requests and instructions which are exchanged among peer OSI layers.
Control information typically takes one of the two forms, that is headers and trailers. Headers are prepended to data that has been passed down from upper layers. Trailers are appended to data that has been passed down from upper layer. The OSI layer is not required to attach a header or trailer to data from upper layers. Headers, trailers, and data are virtual concepts depending on the layer that evaluates the information unit. For example, at the network layer, that is layer 3, the information unit consists of a header and data. However, at the data link layer, that is layer 2, all the information passed down by the network layer, that is the header and the data of layer 3, is considered as data. In other words, the data part of an information unit at a given OSI layer potentially contains headers, trailers, and data from all the higher layers. This is known as encapsulation. Diagram shows how the header and data from one layer are encapsulated as data of the next lowest layer. The information exchange process occurs among peer OSI layers. Each layer in the source system adds control information to data, and each layer in the destination system analyzes and removes the control information from that data. Again, it will be understood by an example. If system I has data from software application to send into system J, the data is passed to the application layer. The application layer in system I then communicates with control information required by the application layer in system J by prepending a header to the data. The resulting information unit, that is the header and the data, is passed to the presentation layer, which prepends its own header containing control information indicated for the presentation layer in system J. The information unit grows in size as each layer prepends its own header and in some cases a trailer that contains control information to be used by its peer layers in system J. At the physical layer, the entire information unit is placed onto the network medium. The physical layer in system J receives the information unit and passes it to the data link layer. The data link layer in system J then reads the control information contained in header prepended by the data link layer in system I. The header is then removed and rest of the information unit is passed to the network layer. Each layer executes the same functions. The layer reads the header from its peer layers, strips it off, and passes the rest information unit to the next upper layer. After the application layer, the data is passed to the recipient software application in system J, exactly in the form in which it was transmitted by the application in system I. Let us see each layer in brief. First, physical layer carries the bit stream through the network at the electrical and mechanical level. States physical means of moving data over network devices. It interfaces between network medium and devices. States optical, electric, and mechanical characteristics, that is, voltage levels, timing of voltage changes, physical data rates, transmission distances, and physical connections. Second, data link layer gets a string of bits and transports it beyond a link, carries the bit stream through the network at electrical and mechanical level, that is, layer 1. It diverts packets into raw bits and raw bits into packets. Framing and error detection. It breaks the bit stream up into frames, computes an error detection code. It communicates each frame separately. Third, network layer. It converts logical network address and names to their physical address, for example, device name to MAC address. Responsible for addressing, determining routes for sending, managing network problems such as packet switching, data congestion, and routing. Breaks the data into smaller units and assembles data. Guards higher layers from details of how the data gets to its destination. Fourth, transport layer. Breaks stream of data into packets. Rebuilds the message from packets. Gives error checking to guarantee error-free data delivery with no losses or duplications. Gives acknowledgement of successful transmissions. Demands retransmission if some packets don't arrive error-free. Gives flow control and error handling. Fifth, session layer. Builds, maintains, and terminates sessions across the network. Responsible for identification, so only the designated parties can participate in the session. Gives synchronization services by planning checkpoints in the data stream. If session fails, only data after the most recent checkpoint needs to be transmitted. Handles who can send data at a certain time and for how long. Sixth, presentation layer. Converts from application to network format and vice versa. All the diverse formats from all sources are made into common uniform format that the rest of the OSI can understand. It is responsible for protocol conversion, character conversions, data encryption, decryption, expanding graphics commands, and data compression. It sets standards for different systems to provide seamless communication from multiple protocol stacks. Seventh, application layer. Used for applications particularly written to run over the network. Permits access to network services that supports applications. Directly represents the services that directly support user applications. For example, file transfer and email. At the end, we will see the common formats of information which are transferred from one computer to another.
The data and control information that is transmitted through internetworks takes diverse forms. The terms used to refer to these information formats are not used consistently in the internetworking industry, but sometimes are used interchangeably. The common information formats consist frames, packets, datagrams, segments, messages, cells, and data units.
A frame is an information unit whose source and destination are data link layer entities. A frame is composed of the data link layer header and possibly a trailer as well as upper layer data. The header and trailer hold control information planned for the data link layer entity in the destination system. Data from upper layer entities is encapsulated in the data link layer header and trailer. A packet is an information unit whose source and destination are network layer entities. A packet is composed of network layer header and possibly a trailer as well as upper layer data. The header and trailer hold control information intended for the network layer entity in the destination system. Data from upper layer entities is encapsulated in the network layer header and trailer. The term datagram generally refers to an information unit whose source and destination are network layer entities that use connectionless network service. The term segment generally refers to an information unit whose source and destination are transport layer entities. A message is an information unit whose source and destination entities exist above the network layer, often at the application layer. A cell is an information unit of a fixed size whose source and destination are data link layer entities. Cells are used in switched environments such as asynchronous transfer mode, ATM, and switched multi-megabit data services, SMDS networks. A cell is composed of the header and payloads. The header contains control information intended for the destination data link layer entity and is typically 5 bytes long. The payload contains upper layer data that is encapsulated in the cell header and is normally 48 bytes long. The length of the header and the payloads field always are at the same for each cell. Data unit is a generic term that refers to a variety of information units. Some common data units are service data units, SDUs, protocol data units, PDUs, and bridge protocol data units, BPDUs. SDUs are information units from upper layer protocols that define a service request to a lower layer protocol. PDU is OSI terminology for a packet. BPDUs are used by the spanning tree algorithm as hello messages.
There was no standard for networks in the early days, and as a result, it was difficult for networks to communicate with each other. The International Organization for Standardization recognized this and researched various networking schemes, and in 1984 introduced the OSI reference model.
The OSI reference model has standards which ensure vendors great compatibility and interoperability between different types of network technologies. The OSI reference model organizes network functions into 7 layers. Each layer provides a service to the layer above it in the protocol specification and communicates with the same layer's software or hardware on other computers. Layer 1 to 4 are concerned with the flow of data from end to end through the network. Layer 5 to 7 are concerned with services to the applications. In this lecture, we also discuss the information formats, and the common information formats consists frames, packets, datagram, segments, messages, cells, and data units.